Hello and welcome back to Let's Play Atom RPG with me, Bring It Dawn. Let's see if we can't settle this old rivalry at the old bridge. Also, before we get into combat, I do want to swap out. Oh, also before I forget, I've had two level ups. One of them happened before last episode when I was driving from Paragon to Krasno. I fought a group of cultists and I think Zulbar is leveled up there. And I forgot to level him up. I don't think he has enough for a perk. He does not. And also, Alexander leveled up at some point. Don't know when he did that. But now he has enough points to use a saber. So if I find a saber, he can use that. And then Fidel will get an upgrade to a Taiga machete. So I'm fine with him using the TT pistol. He only gets the two shots versus the three. But Hexagen, I would like to use the hunting rifle so he gets two shots instead of just the one. Well, we have a ton of this ammunition. We use the SKS. Let's go and make sure they have the right weapons equipped before we get into combat. Alright, so these buses are radiated, so they wouldn't be there. Oh, there they are. It makes sense they would be standing on the bridge itself. That would be more cinematic. Alright, come on, companions. Everybody get up here with me. Alright, quick save and let's go. You quietly approach the company of well-equipped thugs. They seem to be gathered around a freshly dug grave. A tough-looking guy, probably the leader of the men, looks you with an icy, yet also somehow surprised gaze, and addresses you in a low, growling voice. I don't get it. That's it? Does everyone Spock manage to gather to defend his interests? That's the first time Valera Dober's gang was sent for such small fry. Bandits that surround the man start cackling. You quickly understand that nobody else is coming to help you out. An uneasy situation. The bandit is still waiting for your reply without attacking, though. As a working man, a man of business, I completely understand that dirty son of a gun smuggler. He decided to save some money on protection. Decided to sacrifice us. I can respect his wit, but because of him cutting corners in his budget, our throats are also going to be cut. I like you, Grandpa. It's a good trait to respect your chief until death do you part. I'll kill you last. Mierda, that cabron sent us to our doom. I'm hoping you'll get us out of this tight spot, Donnie. But even if not, I'll gladly die by your side. What bravery. That's okay, though. Anyone willing to die here will get his wish granted. Well, I'm actually interested in this one. I know I don't have the luck stat for it, so I'm not going to bother, but I'm curious what would happen here. See, I wouldn't mind killing all of them, but I also want to use one of my special dialogue options, so I'm probably going to go with strength here. Yeah, why would I need reinforcements? I'll kill you all myself. Thanks for digging that grave, too. Saved me a couple of hours. Valera Dober looks at you with disgust, but as he spots your gigantic muscles, his face quickly becomes pale with worry. He looks at his cohorts and squeals like a rodent. So, hey, Polkin, you know the way to the Wounded Tourist Tunnel, right? Lead me there. You're also with me, Vanya. The rest of you, fight that jerk on your own. If you somehow win, bring me his head. Hook will pay you a ton of money. See ya. You watch as a scared bandit escapes the scene along with two companions. Too bad he won't get to kill Dober himself, but the fight is all the easier for it. Come on, suckers. Wow me. Attack. Right. Oh. My character kept running forward. Nice. Good job, Zulbar. I didn't expect you to tank the entire fight, but I appreciate it. Yeah, Zobarz was the MVP of that fight, for sure. Alright, what did we get? Some miscellaneous stuff. I'll take the stimulant. Actually, we'll give it to Alexander. Why not? It'd probably be more worthwhile to have killed the entire gang there. Got more experience out of it, but that's okay. So what did we do? I was duped. Only the enemy showed at the dispute. But now I know where Uncle Hook and his cronies are hiding. An old railroad tunnel with a weird name. Wounded Tourist Tunnel. I'm not familiar with that. I wonder if it's even in the wasteland itself or if it's in like the Dead City. Wounded Tourist Tunnel. Oh, it's right here. Has that always been there? It had to have been added with this quest line, right? By the way, let's set up camp real fast. Heal up a bit, mostly for Zulbar's sake. And just for the sake of expediency, what I'll do is, let's just get going. If I do run across a random encounter, I'll probably avoid it, if I can. So I'm not looking to pick a fight, I'm just looking to... Oh, well, I guess it didn't matter. Alright, so I've never been to this location before, I don't know what to expect. See some mushrooms over here. Guy standing at the gate. Well, not the gate, the tunnel entrance. So Simon didn't show up. I wonder if he betrayed us. Well, I mean, all the dialogue seems to indicate that he has, or did. So I wonder if we'll run across him again, or if he skipped town. Because if he skipped town, is there even any reason for me to come here and take out this gang? Besides, you know, the experience, of course, and the sweet loot. You stop near the large brute who's guarding the tunnel entrance. He already saw you, and is currently in the process of producing a giant machete from behind his back. Your legs failed you, friend. They have led you straight to your doom. I don't threaten me. I break men twice your size. Leave your threats. The giant of a man gives his machete a wide swing and looks at it, mesmerized by the pristine blade. He then turns to you. You cannot see what goes on under his face mask, but seems like he is giving you an icy cold stare, combined with a wicked grin. His glassy eyes are peering straight into your very soul. Today you will learn what pain is. You will curse yourself for not cutting your own legs off. You will curse your mother for giving birth to you. You will beg the silent sky to undo our meeting. To make it all a bad dream, a terrible nightmare. I'll show you pain you never even imagined existed. You will know the whole spectrum of pain, a whole rainbow of suffering. Do not even hope that in time your body will stop responding to the terrible torment I'll inflict on it. Do not hope for an easy, quick death. Oh no, I have methods that will make you squirm in ceaseless agony for days, weeks, months even. You'll try to accept pain's embrace. You will try to befriend it. I won't let you, though. And then you will become nothing but a howling little piece of sanity, locked into a body that resembles a huge open wound. Oh, I hope you will be canonized after death. You'll be a saint in a way, a martyr of sorts, because you will die for your faith, your belief. For your empty, nonsensical belief that you did nothing to earn such a gruesome end. The big man swings his large knife again, and laughs hysterically. Uh-huh. Cool story, bro. Oh, alright, he's got grenades. I was half expecting him. Oh, wait. Marshall's gun's out. Did I swap those back? My bad. Let me fix that real fast. I was half expecting him to get killed by somebody, like maybe Simon shows up and shoots him in dialogue. Well, he has a tiger machete. Let's give that to Fidel. Let's drop all this stuff off in case there's a bunch of loot in this tunnel. I guess I also have that backpack in case if push comes to shove. Alright, Fidel, you equip this. We'll hold on to that. Well, let's go ahead and put it in the trunk. Alright. Let's head into the Wounded Tourist Tunnel. New location. Don't know what to expect, but it's exciting. I'm excited to discover something new. I'm not gonna pick up microchips. Actually, let me make sure this isn't like a dead end. No, it just keeps going, doesn't it? Okay, so that's the way we have to go. Let's explore these side tunnels. Also, I'm pretty sure these are spider eggs and spider webs, so I'm wondering there's spiders here now? Let's check. Nope, don't see any. So I'm wondering if you come here before you get this quest, if it's filled with spiders, but since I came here after the quest, I missed my chance to fight all the spiders. Pretty sure this wasn't a location initially. This was added for this quest, if I'm not mistaken. I'm also curious what happened to Simon, if he actually betrayed us. So initially when they said Wounded Tourist Tunnel, I assumed that would be a Dead City location, since this is the big Dead City patch. Actually, I don't know if the Krasno Catacombs was added with the Dead City patch or if that was its own independent update. Because I was trying to avoid spoilers when the patch notes were coming out, so I didn't ruin any of the quests for me. Steps on this side. Also a ramp into the train right there. I don't need the scrap metal. I'm not going to bother picking that up. Alexander, can you hold onto this old boot for me? Thanks, man. I'm not gonna bother picking that stuff up. I can start being a little selective about the loot that I pick up. Well, you know what? Let's grab it. It's not like I have to carry it. It's all on Alexander. And I have infinite inventory space in the vehicle, so if we do get over-encumbered, I could just run back, drop it off, and keep on trucking. So let's grab this other stuff. You guys stuck over here? What are y'all doing? Having a party that I wasn't invited to? pine cone. This is an average pine cone and nothing more. Makes me suspect that it's something more than just an average pine cone. I think you can find those in the Roaring Forest as well, right? I know I left a microchip back there. We'll grab it on the way out if I remember. Not the end of the world. They don't sell for a whole lot. Selling, they're actually worth grabbing. They weigh a ton, and no one really buys them for like a really good price or anything. I'm finding plenty of tea that I needed for that one quest. How's he sitting? Okay, so I have some inventory space left. They feel like he'll just run past those guys. Oh, this is like a fan from a ventilation shaft. So I wonder if this guy tried to hang himself with this rope. And ended up dying here anyway after that failed. Another pine cone. Interesting. Interesting. Why are they in this tunnel? Alright, before I get up here to these guys, come on, companions. There's Hexogen. Alexander's coming. Where's Fidel? There he is. So it looks like he's going to go and run all the way around. We'll wait for him to catch up. I don't want to pick a fight with this group of guys until I have everyone with me. Come on, old man. Darn it, Alexander's running off. He's still moving though, so I can wait for him to catch back up while I'm in dialogue. A tough, well-armed man looks at you with an icy glare, then lifts his hand, ordering his comrades to take aim. Where are you heading, kid? You're not welcome here. Show the man your massive fists. Here are my invitations, left one and right one. The man is deeply distraught by your bulk. He carefully asks, okay, you're huge. So, we're still ordered not to let you through. You see my perfection, worm. Run while you still can. I'm graciously giving you this one-in-a-lifetime opportunity, you unwashed plebe. Man scratches his chin deep in thought, and finally roars. You're massive, and you'll probably hand my butt to me, but I'll still fight you. Nobody insults me and gets away with it. Kill him, guys. Attack. So be it. Oh, I should have attacked first then. I had the opportunity to. Oh, my companions are wounded. This might get ugly. Especially with Fidel knocked down. Good job, Alexander. Alright, let's see if I can take this guy out. No. Oh, well, he's knocked down. It's the next best thing. Good job, Hexogen. Wait, what is he using? Oh, he had the hunting rifle equipped, I guess not. Don't usually see Alexander take this much damage. He's getting pretty messed up. So am I. Oh, Zulbarz is knocked down too. Alright, I need to heal up after this. He should also heal up. I'm a little nervous for Alexander. He does have healing that he can heal himself up, so I'm not super worried about it. I'm a little nervous, though. Yep, see? And that's why. Cool. So when he heals up, he can still attack twice. Well, good for him. Okay, it looks like we got this in the bag. We don't need to waste ammunition on the last guy, so swap to your melee weapons. He's using his fists. It's not like he's a threat. Alright, so there's a door here. What's in here? More people. So that's probably another fight. They probably need to heal up before that fight. I might be able to get away with just me healing up, because if they're through a doorway, right? Yeah, so if I can get in there before my companions do, they should just focus on me. So I shouldn't have to do any unnecessary healing. I cannot talk today. He's pushing his weight limit. I can carry just a little more. Did I loot? I lost track of which ones I looted. I think it's these three, right? Yeah. Alright, Alexander, you hold on to that, and I guess I'll carry the rest. Or did I loot everybody? It looks like... No, this guy still has stuff. Let us quick save to avoid. There we go. I guess we'll eat a cracker as well just to get our health maxed out. Did I miss a key or something? I'm assuming I can lockpick it, but the fact that it's locked in the first place after fighting these guys makes me think that one of them had a key. Or I didn't loot somebody because someone should be carrying a key. Right? Nope. Okay. Well, I guess if you just can't lockpick, you can't get past this point. Unless it's just a really easy lockpick. Oh. Okay. Well, that explains it. In we go. I really don't need the scrap and the microchip. We're pushing our encumbrance level. Diesel. I really don't need any more diesel either. I think I need 30 and I have more than 30. Might be 40. Or even 50. I don't remember. But you do need a good chunk of diesel. For a quest later on. And you have to have it. Like, you can't get around it. Unless they've changed it since last time I played. Alright, Alexander, we're just gonna over-encumber you. Because I can't be over-encumbered for the fight. But you can. Because you're just there to soak up bullets, not, whoops. Not deal damage. Come on. There we go. Then again, I can loot all this stuff on the way out and then just equip a backpack. So I don't have to worry about combat anymore. Yeah, don't need the microchips. They weigh so much for nothing. Like, you don't gain anything out of hauling all those around. Because it's still, what, 1,000 at Bunker 317? Alright, I'll swap back to all those other weapons. I'm just gonna run in. There we go. I pull all their aggro. A buff man and his cohorts all turn to look at you as you enter the room. He then smiles, with only slight worry in his eyes. Who are you, buddy? Why are you here? Yeah, I'm the guy your people almost killed during the meeting. Ah, I see. So why did you come to me? Did Shpak leave you in the dirt, and now you're looking for another boss? Yeah, I don't know why I'm here. It just happened this way, I guess. Just freaking happened? Amazing. Who knew someone would try to kill me because of a little misunderstanding? Because of the intrigues created by a mutual friend. You know who I'm talking about, right? No? Well, let me explain. You found our little letter in the tree hollow, right? Here's a fun little detail for you. Before we got to that courier and decapitated him, he gave all the drugs to a guy sent by Simon Shpak. He made a fool out of you. Seems like your buddy Shpak decided to make a fool out of you. That's a little redundant, he just said that. He sent someone for the goods beforehand, and when you would have returned empty-handed, he would have blamed you for the disappearance. Quite the plan, right? He gets all the drugs and throws you under the bus as the scapegoat. We messed with his plan, though. What a poorly timed coincidence. If it wasn't for our wish to leave a sign for Shpak's people by executing his courier, you'd have no beef with us. Alas, now I have to finish what my stupid cronies couldn't. I don't want to chase them out of here, so I wonder if I do this if I still have the option to fight. So when I did the strength check with that other group, we still got to fight, so I'm going to try this. If we don't get to fight them, I'm going to reload so we can fight them. Get out of here. You know I'm stronger. The man laughs nervously and looks around. You can tell he sees how big and tough you are compared to him. Calm down, okay? No need for threats. I'm a sane man, and I sure can tell I'm defeated. We will leave this part of the waste forever, right now. Oh, cool. I changed my mind. You need to die, weaklings. Attack. Oh, I didn't see this guy over here. That was just the four of them. He's got a battle gauntlet. I'm a little nervous with the battle gauntlet. I've seen what Hexagen can do with it, so I'm gonna rush this guy and stand on this side of him. I'm definitely taking all the damage like I wanted to do, so I guess it is working. Oh no. Oh no. Oh, I didn't get to stand up. Oh no. Yeah, Simon's gonna kill me. Or not Simon, what's his face? Yeah. Shoot. Alright, I have condensed milk. Let's buff up my endurance. And that should do. Yeah, last fight, instead of attacking with a chainsaw, I should have healed up. Let me quick save one more time, I'm a little nervous. All I pick the same options. Oh no! Yeah, now he's gonna get messed up by that guy. Shoot. Let's try and make him run away. That's why he's stunned. Alright, so I know what I need to do. I need to move my character over here. Take him out, then pull their aggro. Try and keep Zilbars alive. There we go. That should do it. They should all focus me now and not Zulbars at all. Alexander's doing his part, that's good. Shouldn't have to heal here, there's only the three of them left. Alexander's tanking one of them for me. Nope, Alexander, what are you doing, man? Alexander, you idiot, go over here. Why, he was closer to that guy, why would he go this way? Actually, you know what? Here. I need a tank. I can't risk Alexander not making it over here in time to save Zulbars. He was closer to this guy. I don't know why he was closer, right? Maybe he was closer to this guy. Standing right here. No, that's closer to this guy. Yeah, I don't know what he's doing. Not what he's supposed to be doing, that's for sure. Nope, run away, run away! Oh, run away! No! Shoot at me, buddy. Shoot at me. Thank you. Alright. Whew, that was nerve-wracking. AI was doing some wonky stuff there. Alright, we'll loot the bodies at the end. I'm gonna equip the backpack because we're definitely gonna need that. Not gonna bother with that. Don't care about the microchips at all. Alright, well, that went pretty smoothly the second time around. A custom air pistol. Some say a gun with a compressed air-driven projectile is nothing on real guns. These people have never taken a shot in the eye from one of these bad boys. Homemade? I've never seen one of these. Neat. Only has one shot in it before you have to reload, though. Doesn't seem that great. More diesel that I don't need. Oh, I am glad I killed these guys. Some rare ammunition and another battle gauntlet. I wonder. What's Alexander's martial arts at? It might be worth giving him that instead. I went to the wrong menu. He has 92. He can use the battle gauntlet. Let's give that to him as well. We'll have him try out both of them. I think the battle gauntlet's gonna be better. The biggest appeal for the Taiga Machete on a companion is the chance to cause panic on the enemies, or in the enemies. drugged up. That's fine. I'm encumbered because I'm drugged. Gosh darn it. So I was wondering if Dober was going to be here, but it doesn't look like he shows up here. If you spare him at the other place. By spare him, I mean chase him off. Yeah, just a little over encumbered. Darn. Can I risk dropping anything? Eh, I mean, screw it. We just have to walk to the entrance. It's not the biggest dungeon. Just double check all their hands, make sure I didn't leave anything behind. Okay, cool. Well, let's get out of here. I think we explored the whole tunnel, yep. Well, neat. A new location. All that jazz. Actually, you know what? This is going to take a while, and we're over time, so I'm going to call the episode here. Off camera, I'm going to go back to Krasno. I'm going to see if Simon is there. I have a feeling he's not going to be there. But if he is, we'll start next episode by talking to Simon. If not, we'll start the next episode in Fokolefka with the lawman. We'll talk to him about the two people we've spoken to about Chigarov already, and then we'll head to the Mountain Pass of Woes finally. So anyway, thanks for watching. I hope to see you guys in the next episode.